Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we're here in Vegas for CES conference, and we are at the Acer booth with Eric. Good morning, Eric. How's it going?
Morning. Doing all right.
Nice to meet you. So I see we have these three great laptops that we're going to be talking about. So why don't you take us through all of them?
So the first of the products is the Acer Aspire Vero 16. This is an important product for us because we focus on sustainability. We've been doing this for about 2 years. Now we've refreshed the product with a few key features to point out. First, we went from about 30% post-consumer recycled plastics, now 60%. We've also integrated the new Meteor Lake CPUs from Intel on all three of these products. So what's really cool is we can take advantage of that. We've had an AI application for a while called Acer Purified Voice. Now we have version 2 that makes use of that NPU to do a better job with sound isolation and beamforming for conversations through the PC. So we've gone from 2 digital microphones to 3 strategically placed in the chassis to do a very good job of following you when you're having any kind of conversation through the device, to beamform, pick it up, and remove background noise. And they're placed in the chassis to avoid any kind of noise from the system itself.
Okay, so you were telling me that you have gone from 30% to 60% on using a recycled product. So
yes.
Can you tell us a little bit more about like the feel and...
So it's a very interesting tactile feel to this system. It doesn't feel like a typical plastic chassis or PCR chassis. There's a little bit of a texture to it. We've also integrated some little symbols to highlight that this is part of that Vero line. There is also a different material called mica, little dots of mica in there that add color and pizzazz to make it visually appealing, but also to help that material bond and be stronger.
Nice, nice. So this is, I like it. I like the feel. It's very different, but I like the whole look and feel for the computer. So let's talk about a little bit about the different ports that it provides.
So as an industry as a whole, we're moving towards more use with USB Type-C for power. As you saw, it was plugged in, so we're delivering power through there, also having that for great connectivity for speed and performance. We continue to have HDMI and support older devices with USB Type-A.
And over here we have more USB Type-A. We have the Kensington lock, which comes really handy, especially in conference events like this, or you have your laptop laying outside. And you have an audio jack.
An audio jack, yeah. So works for both mic and headset through that. And then I think it's important to point out too that we have a fingerprint reader here to help secure the device with Windows Hello.
Oh, nice, that's pretty good. So I also saw here in the camera, you also have a physical shutter.
So we have started to make improvements to our overall product line, and these three definitely benefit from it. The quality of the camera has gone up, so it's QHD camera, but also now integrated camera shutter, like you pointed out. This way you don't have to have a piece of tape or a post-it note on there. It looks really silly. This is more effective.
Nice, nice, thank you. And you said that these come on different configurations, goes from like Intel Core Ultra.
So we'll probably start with a Core Ultra 5, and then we'll go up to a Core Ultra 7. RAM configurations go up to 32 gigabytes. Storage goes up to 2 terabytes.
Nice. Oh, well, that's pretty good. Thank you. So, all right, let's talk about this one. What is new in this one?
So more exciting in the product lineup as we move down the line, the Swift Go 14. This is a thin and light Evo edition product for us. Aluminum chassis. It has a really good feel to it. Beautiful OLED panel with multiple certifications to make sure it's a good experience for the user. So you get something called TUV Rheinland Eyesafe 2.0 certification. Mm-hmm. That's a pair of hardware and software put together to reduce the blue light emission from the system.
Right.
It also has something called IMAX certification. And when using IMAX certified media, it does a much better job of displaying the colors and the brightness through the HDR settings as the content creator intended. Finally, it also has a Visa HDR 500 True Black certification, so you're getting a really good contrast with the black versus dark on the screen. And yes, this is using the new Ultra Core up to Core Ultra 9 series of processors. A really neat feature to highlight, though, is the fact that when you play media on the device, and it can be from a web page or a media file, the touchpad will illuminate and have more touch-sensitive functions for a media controller built in. And then when a user moves away, that'll disappear, and it's just a very good, accurate touchpad.
For this system, who's the target audience that you're looking
for? I'd say primarily students and business people on the go.
Okay, so you're road warriors like us right now.
Exactly.
So, that's awesome. All right, so now let's talk a little bit more about this guy over here.
The Swift X14 retains that thin and light chassis, but we add performance. So we've integrated a discrete GPU from NVIDIA. We'll go up to the NVIDIA RTX 4070 for the graphics. The panel is also enhanced over the Swift Go. So the refresh rate on the Swift Go, we didn't mention earlier, is 90 hertz. We get up to 120 hertz on the Swift X. Another feature of this OLED panel that makes it different and better for content creators is it has Kalman verification, which is color accuracy in the white space.
Nice. So this pretty much says like the target audience for this guy is content creators for all the different aspects that you've been saying.
Absolutely, yes.
Nice, nice. And this guy, I mean, since intended for content creators, you can see, I was looking at it earlier, it has a micro SD slot right here, the USB, and then you also have your Kensington lock. And then on the other side, we have, you know, your HDMI output, USB-C with Thunderbolt 4, and your audio jack.
Audio once more, yeah.
It's really nice. I like it. It's compact.
Small, light, portable, meets the needs of those people that are getting more performance-oriented work done.
Nice. So I also heard you have some gaming laptops.
We have some amazing products to talk about.
All right, Eric. So now here we have all the, I think this is your gaming lineup, right?
Yes. So we're talking about the Predator brand, the high performance level of gaming for us. First of the products is the Predator Helios Neo. This is available in two screen sizes, 16 and 18. Now this slots just a little bit below the more full-fledged Predator Helios, also available in 16 and 18 inch screen sizes. There are a little bit of differences here because we're positioning differently. The Neo, we're trying to bring Predator down, make it more affordable for more people. So we're not gonna configure it quite the same way. We won't go quite as extreme.
Nice, nice. So I see that these two guys, the Helios Neo and the Helios, have the Intel 14th gen processors in them.
Absolutely, and these are running HX, so we're pushing high performance here.
Nice, yes. These are kind of the top of the line.
That's right.
This is great. One thing that caught my eye is the refresh rate of these screens. You know, this is for gamers, so that's one thing that is very important to them.
Yeah, so even though the Neo is a little bit down in overall performance and specs, it still goes up to a 240 hertz refresh. That is an option on one of the panels. Full-fledged Helios, however, goes up to 250 hertz refresh with a mini LED panel.
Nice, and that will be this guy over here.
That's correct.
Nice, and also you see you have different configurations when it comes to discrete GPUs.
Right, so to help separate on the Neo side, the max GPU is up to RTX 4070, and actually we've introduced a lower end. We used to stop at 4060, now we will go down to 4050, so we're spreading out the product line a little bit. But on the full-fledged Predator Helios, all the way up to the RTX 4090.
Nice, nice. I really like what you guys done. So we were talking earlier about the differences on the keyboard and the lighting from one to the other. Can you tell us a bit more?
So yeah, there are a little bit of differences to help encourage people to step up to get more with the full-fledged Helios. On the Helios Neo, we have mini LEDs to light the keyboard, but it's a four-zone keyboard. On the Helios, it's a per-key mini LED, and there's far greater control for the lighting and the activity that happens. There's also a few other cosmetic changes. There's no logo on the palm rest area here, but there is on the full-fledged Helios. On the back, there's a logo on both with more control for lighting on the full-fledged Helios. And then finally, the light bar on the back has lights on the Helios, but not on the Helios Neo.
Gotcha, that makes sense.
But there is actually a key difference between the two on the keyboard as well. With the Helios, we include a set of replaceable switches, not just the keycap, mm-hmm. but switches for WASD. So we have two sets in there. One is for a more tactile feel, and one is more linear, get pressure sensitive.
Oh, nice. So you can actually, depending on what you like, you can have one or the other, and you can just change them. Oh, that's nice.
So something consistent across all of the Predator products is our focus on performance. So our thermal solution is top notch. We have our fifth generation Aeroblade 3D fan, which is metal blades. It's designed in-house, different curves and ridges and
heat pipes and
different fans. All that. So the fan does a great job to make sure there's no spot where there's no airflow. Then we're using a new thermal interface material. Instead of a tape, we're using a liquid metal material.
Oh,
so
nice.
It bonds better and transfers heat better. And finally, we've made an upgrade to the heat pipe. It's now what we call a vector heat pipe. Mm-hmm. It's a rectangular shape instead of oval or round. So there's more contact and more surface area to help draw heat out.
Oh, that makes sense. So you could, the transfer of the heat from the processor to the heat pipe and out through the fan. That's pretty cool. Right. So let me take a quick look because I found this. It's my friend, RJ. RJ45. I actually get pretty excited when I find one of these. And we also have your regular, your USB type A. You have a micro SD, your audio jack,
yes.
And on this side, we have more USB ports. This is great.
And
oh,
and
the
more on the back.
Sorry,
yeah.
I completely, yes. On the back, of course, we have power, HDMI, and you have your USB-C with Thunderbolt in there. So this is pretty cool. I really like it.
You know, since you highlighted that really kind of hidden and bonus RJ45, we are using killer networking here. So there's great bandwidth prioritization that the user can control on the device, in the software, Predator Sense software. They don't have to go to the router to do that.
Oh, nice. So you can prioritize your traffic.
Your
right
gaming,
from here.
Your streaming, and, you know, stop Outlook checking in the background.
Yeah. So he's like, hey, we know my game is first. Outlook, maybe.
I'm not working now.
Exactly. That's awesome. All right. So these two are great, but I see that you have here another one. It seems more like for the road warriors. Tell me a little bit about it.
So the Predator Triton Neo 16 is part of the thin and light line. The Triton is more what I would call an executive gaming device, because you get all the power that you would want for gaming, but a little more sleek and portable chassis. As you can see, it's pretty darn thin.
Yeah, it is pretty thin. It's pretty sturdy too.
So it's a nice aluminum chassis, and we've refreshed this product now with the new Meteor Lake product. So it's now using the Core Ultra series of processors. The graphics capability, because it is thin and light, we're focused on portability, does not go all the way up to the RTX 4090. Mm-hmm. As a Triton Neo, thin, light, and kind of a step down in that family, we're going to max out at the RTX 4070, but you do get 140 watt TGP. So we're really making sure it's a good, solid performance.
Nice. And I think you were talking also that there is a technology in here that will help you on battery life when it comes to, like, you included a MUX that will let you.
Yeah, so across the line, we have made sure that users have the ability to use Advanced Optimus to kind of prioritize using AI when to use the GPU and not, and shut it down for battery life. But there's also MUX switch, so user can turn off the GPU or turn off the integrated GPU and make sure they're using the full power of the discrete GPU.
Right, this is great. And also, since, you know, for us road warriors, they're always on the road, and this is a great gaming device. And with Intel Core Ultra, you know, with all the optimizations that they have when it comes to battery savings, this is definitely gonna help you, you know, game on the go.
Yeah, so you get power, you get performance, but you get efficiency. Also, you're getting that great cooling solution we have to guarantee sustained performance by keeping everything cool and running well. Also, longevity of the system, there's far less chance for failure when you're cooling the components properly.
So let's say you take out the I/O ports. So you have here for your power, you have your USB-C, and also your Thunderbolt, your audio jack. And then over here you have, you know, your HDMI output, and you have your USB-A, oh, and your micro SD card. Awesome. Yeah, like you said, it's a great on the road gaming system.
You know, I think there's actually another segment of user this applies to. Mm-hmm. The power user, the content creator, they want the performance of a gaming laptop, but they don't necessarily want the look and feel. So it's a little more subdued, a little more professional looking, but also thin, light, portable.
Right, then there's that overlap for gamers and content creators. And yeah, like, I can take this around as be as my, you know, my day work laptop, and it's gonna scream me now like, oh, that's a gamer laptop.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. Eric, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
You bet.